Hi guys, and welcome back to our channel. Today we'll be talking about one of the very exciting topics nowadays, Web3. We'll be going through what's Web3, how to use it, how it can benefit you and your projects and your businesses. So without any further ado, let's just dive deep into the topic.
So guys, we start now with the basics. What's Web3 in the first place? Well, simply speaking here, Web3 is a decentralized internet built on blockchain network that's not owned or controlled by large entities, meaning it's decentralized. Decentralized here means that it has no governing entity, and that's a very huge benefit for Web3. Web3, simply speaking here also, is a third generation of the internet and is currently being built where websites and apps will be able to process information in a smart human-like way through technologies such as artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, big data, decentralized ledger technologies, DLT, and more and more. So there is a transition between Web3 and Web2, or from Web2 to Web3. And currently, as we speak, we're currently in an era of 2.5. That can be prolongated for a while here because we still need a smooth transition into a full Web3 development over here. So Web3 is existing, but it's still in the development stage. It's still functional, of course, and many projects, many companies, many services are using Web3 right now, but it still has a lot of room to grow and it still has a lot of potential. So things can take 5 to 10 years to have a fully developed Web3, and we can rely on it completely. But now we're currently stuck in Web 2.5, meaning that we're still in the transition phase between Web 2 and Web 3. And here you can define Web 3, to expand the definition here, as an interconnected in a decentralized way, meaning that the data is not stored in the conventional way or the classic way as Web 2. Web 2 stores data in a centralized storage, but not with Web 3. Web 3 doesn't store data in centralized storage. It stores data in a decentralized storages. And here, furthermore, here you can see that users, machine will be able to interact with data. But for this happening, the programs need to understand information both conceptually and contextually here, and with the mind that two cornerstones of Web3 and semantic web, artificial intelligence technologies, meaning that things need some development here for everything or every aspect of Web3 to understand and connect with each other. So what's the development of Web3? The development, the evolution of Web3, or the development of Web3, started back then. It started way back from Web 1. I mean, it's kind of a continuation of Web 1. Web 1 was the basics, was in the 80s and 90s. It's just a small group of people generating content for wider audience. And then Web 2 consists of millions of users, and that was a massive spike in the internet usage. Of course, 2000 till present now, everything you use right now is just a Web 2. So it's kind of widely known, widely used, and Web3 now is kind of taking that away and starting to start a new generation or a new revolution in the whole internet usage. As you can see here, Web2 is referred as a socially interactive web, while Web1 is known as the read-only web, meaning that only one person is creating content and everyone else is using it, or everyone else is reading it. It's just a read only. But Web2, you can upgrade, you can put your effort, you can upload your videos, you can just, you know, you have the capability of JavaScript, as you can see here, and you have the capabilities of uploading your own content. But with Web3, that will represent the next step in the internet growth, enabling it to be comprehended information in a near human way, meaning that it will be a seamless interaction in a very human-like manner on Web3. So in other words here, Web3 is just impacting to have a new enhanced decentralized internet environment independent of any kind of central authority. That's the major benefit of Web3, is it doesn't have any entity controlling the internet or owning that portion of the internet. So that will give you a lot of flexibility, especially when you're using NFTs or DApp, which is decentralized apps. This will open new opportunities and new horizons for many possibilities in the future. So how does it work? Well, the concept behind the Web3 is to make the internet search much quicker and simpler and more efficient so that the system may process even complex search queries in no time whatsoever, and the user much engaged with the Web2 application front end with connects to the its back end, which runs and interacts with the database. The complete source code here is maintained on centralized services and sent to consumers via the internet browser. That's Web2, but Web3, that's not really the case here, because Web3 lacks centralized databases that maintain application information, and the centralized web has. No, that's not going to be the case. It will be decentralized. Remember that word, decentralized. It's not controlled and it's not stored in a centralized place, and the developers design your app's functionality in a smart contract place into the decentralized state machine. Again, decentralized here, meaning that the functionality here will be based upon smart contracts. You might have heard this term before, smart contracts, meaning that it's no human interference here. It's a smart contract. If certain requirements are met, then a contract is executed or an order is executed here. So that will allow Web3 to have a very flexible way and in a very human-like way to interact and execute orders and develop projects and develop further development over here. Numerous Web3 protocols are highly reliant on Bitcoin. Instead, it provides monetary and incentives, that's tokens, to anyone helps to start, control, donate, or whatever they want to do in the project. So Web3 tokens are electronically linked and decentralizing the internet as a whole. So they are quite a key factor here for the development of Web3. And here you can also find that the working of Web3 is kind of basic, and it's relying on the blockchain technology. Blockchain technology, of course, is a major technology, and it has been emerging in the last few years, and it's taking the whole entire world by storm. And of course, you will have a lot of benefits using the Web3, and you will have a lot of advantages using the Web3. But let's talk about the benefits and the importance of Web3 and how you can rely on that into having the great features or the great benefits of using Web3. If you use Web3 here, let's go to the benefits of Web3. If you use Web3 here, you will have a better search engine optimization. SEO will be optimized more. If you use the decentralized web or the Web3, you will find here that utilizing a search engine in a natural language is extremely efficient. Businesses may optimize their sites for search results in a highly manageable way and highly organic manner as well, instead of using complex keyword strategies. So it will be seamless, and it will be just very intuitive and very fluid in terms of search engine optimization. This will also give you the opportunity to have an improved data operations. IDOs here are quite interesting, because that will be a result of decentralized information storage. This will give access to data under any circumstance, give numerous backups to a system in the event of server crash or whatever. There are no server crashes in blockchain, meaning that the data is decentralized, scattered all over the place. You will have no downtime whatsoever, but of course this will need some development. And then you will have the more purpose creator economy here. That's quite an interesting topic. As I told you, in Web2, you can actually put your content, but you don't own your content. You know, big entities own the content, but it's not going to be the case with Web3. Web3 emergence has held here a bright prospect for all content developers. Most content producers fight to realize the actual value of their work due to the many routes and intermediates the use or the reach of their audience. But here Web3 will be just, I mean, it will facilitate such as tokenizations and will provide significant advantage for all sorts as well. So Web3 will be a creator economy, and this will also increase reliability. Of course, it will be a very reliable form of the internet. It will have less crashes, it will have less security issues. Everything will be more reliable in such a way that the decentralization will result in storing all data on various nodes. As a result, of course, users will not have to bother about canceling a specific account or service outage, caused by technical issues. As I told you here, it will be decentralized, will be scattered all over the place, and things will be very, very efficient in the way they're working, in a very reliable way. And of course, democratized collaboration, that's DAOs. DAOs here are decentralized autonomous organizations, meaning that it's non-human organization. Of course, it's based on smart contracts, and it's powered by that's powering the Web3. That will be a revolutionary management structure devoted, that will be also kind of acting as a CEO and governing factor for how the Web3 is working. The DAO function here, according to a set of codes rule, smart contracts enabling infinite number of participants within the next 10 to 15 years, and it's anticipated that many conventional businesses will switch to DAOs. And you might have heard now that many businesses are already switching to DAO and already relying on the DAOs or the DAO concept to execute their business, and shifting to Web3 slowly, slowly over here. And of course, it will have transparency and customization. This will be also a great benefit of using the Web3. So Web3 gives you all these advantages and all these promises and all these potential in the future. Of course, it's still in development, and of course, many possibilities and many opportunities can be opened right now because it's in a very early stage and it's still in development. And once it takes off severely, things can just go crazy and things can go wild. And of course, if you're over 20 years old, of course you know that in the early 2000s things were starting to take off with Web 2, or like the usage of Web 2. So now we're kind of seeing a similar approach here with Web 3. So I would advise you to have a look at what's going on here and inform yourself more and get more involved in the process, because Web 3 will be the major dominating factor on the internet. It will be the internet. Internet will be Web3. And until then, I would highly advise you to check it out and inform yourself more and get more involved in such a concept and in the projects built on Web3.
So guys, in a summary, we talked about Web3, what it is, how to use it, and how to benefit from using Web3. So as usual, if you like this video, hit the thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, leave any comment you might have in the comment section down below. And as usual, then next time. Bye-bye.